Hi children, I am here today to teach you the geography first lesson of SSC state syllabus, both from Telangana and from Andhra. And the first geographical lesson is India and the relief futures. And is it a new word for you, relief futures? It is not at all a new word. The meaning of the relief futures is the physical futures. You are learning from your primary classes onwards. In the 9th class also you learned how the earth formed. So, due to some geographical situations, the big landform was separated from the sun, and after cooling, two types of big land plates are formed. One is Angara and the second one is the Gondwana. Our India comes under the Gondwana landform. So when after forming this Gondwana landform, it split from the earth, from other part of the earth, and this Gondwana formed, and it collided with the Angara, and mountains also formed after cooling this one. So let us learn about this in detail. Here, one thing I want to make you clear that where are the mountains, physical features means mountains, plains and plateaus, etc. So that each and everything where they are situated in the northern part or in the southern part, east or west, everything I am going to explain you a clear way on the map. Here with the flow charts, this lesson I want to explain you with the flow charts so that you can remember it very easily. Now coming to the location of the India, you know, I hope you know what are longitudes. These vertical lines are the longitudes and these are the latitudes. So this is the equator. What is the upper part? That is the northern hemisphere, and the down one is the southern hemisphere. India is situated in the northern hemisphere, and important latitude, that is Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees latitude, is passing almost through the middle of the India. Here Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, a little part of Rajasthan, here Chhattisgarh, and in the eastern part, Mizoram, Manipur and Mizoram, that are the parts which this Tropic of Cancer is passing through. So that is about the latitude. And what is the location and extent, how much it extended, we can see the longitudes. The longitudinal east side, India is situated to the eastern side of the longitude, and that is 68 degrees 7 minutes east longitude to 97 degrees 25 minutes east longitude. Then coming to the latitude, it is 8 degrees 4 minutes north to 37 degrees 6 minutes north latitude is the extension of India, location and extent. And now let us learn about the relief futures, because it is extending from north 8 to 37, and longitude east from this side to this side, a variety of climatic conditions, landforms are there, varieties of different types of landforms are there, because some places are very near to the sea, some are far off places to the sea. So let us learn about that relief futures. Now, how many relief futures are there? There are 6 types of relief futures are there in India. They are the Greater Himalayas. First one is the Greater Himalayas. Then second one is the Indo-Gangetic Plain. And the third one is the Peninsular Plateau. Fourth one is the Coastal Plain. Fifth, Desert. And the 6th, Islands. I am repeating one. Himalayas, Indo-Gangetic Plains, Peninsular Plateau region, Coastal Plains, the Deserts and the Islands. Now let us learn about Himalayas, the first one. So I'll draw a flow. So this is the flow chart for you. Greater Himalayas, Lesser Himalayas, Shivaliks. Himalayas are divided into 3 parts. The northernmost means the top part is known as the Greater Himalayas, and south to the Greater Himalayas, Lesser Himalayas, and south to Lesser Himalayas is the Shivaliks. Greater Himalayas, Lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks. And when compared to the sea height, 6,100 meters height from the sea level, these greater Himalayas, and when compared to the lesser Himalayas is 3,700 to 4,500 meters height. And next Sivaliks is the 900 to 1100 meters height from the sea level. If we see in the greater Himalayas, all the world's highest peaks and highest peaks in India, everything, the highest peaks are situated in the greater Himalayas. For example, I am quoting two examples here, Mount Everest and K2. So this one, coming to the lesser Himalayas. After this greater Himalayas, let us learn about the lesser Himalayas. This lesser Himalayas, as you know, from 3,700 to 4,500 meters height from the sea level. And important mountains in this place are Pirpanjal and Mahabharat. And next, coming to the Shivaliks. Here in this Shivaliks is 900 to 1100 meters height from the sea. 900 to 1100 meters height from the sea level. And here there are hills. In this Shivalik places, we can see only hills. And the hills are known according to the location where they are, in which state they are known with their local names, like Jammu Hills and Mishi Hills, like that. And the place, the valleys between the lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks, they are known as the dunes. You got an idea, no? Dehradun, yes. Yes, Dehradun and some other dunes are also there here. Kotli dune, Patali dune are also there here. And the places near the Brahmaputra Valley, they are known as the Purvanchal. They are known as the Purvanchal, and here in this Purvanchal, this is near the Arunachal Pradesh. And Naga Hills, Manipuri Hills in the Manipuri, and Kashi Hills and Mizo Hills. These are the some of the local names of the Shivalik Hills. And the land between the Lesser Himalayas and Shivaliks is known as the dunes. Just now, as I said. And coming to the next important one is the Indo-Gangetic Plains. These Indo-Gangetic Plains are also again into three parts. They are the western part, central part, and the eastern part. This western part covers valley is covered with the sedimentary rock and fertile eroded plain. Coming to the Indo-Gangetic Plain. This Indo-Gangetic Plain is again three parts: west, east, and the central part. Western part is covered with the Indus Valley River, and the central is the Ganga River, and this one is the eastern part is with the Brahmaputra River. So the fertile land, eroded land bought by the Indus River and filled the valleys with the fertile land. So that plains are very fertile land. They are very good for the agriculture. This Indus River, as it is from the north, it is flowing and coming to the downwards. It is giving only 20% of its water is utilized by our India, and the remaining it was utilized by the Pakistan, as it is the border. And this Indus River is having some tributaries. They are like Satluj, Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum. They are the tributaries. With the help of these tributaries only, the fertile land, the valley is filled with the fertile land. And the second one is the central one. The central land is valleys are filled. The central plains are filled with the river of the Ganga, Yamuna, Jamuna, like that. Ganga, main river is Ganga, and Jamuna, Yamuna, they are the tributaries of the Ganga. So the valleys which were filled by these rivers, they were known as the central lays. This is also very fertile land. And by the eastern part near the Arunachal Pradesh, like one U-pin shape. Bending is there, no? So that is the places they are covered by this one. These Brahmaputra, these valleys are filled with the fertile land, fertile land of this Brahmaputra river, bought by the Brahmaputra. And coming to the next relief feature, that is next physical division, is the Peninsular Plateau. This also again into three parts, we can learn it into three parts, Peninsular Plateau. Just I'll explain everything again on the map with a clear situation. Here, if we see the Peninsular Plateau, it is downwards towards the east side when compared to the west. So, here is the Malwa Plateau, west side, and here is the Chota Nagpur Plateau, and the remaining plateau is, this plateau is known as the Deccan Plateau. This place is known as the Deccan Plateau region. So, this is about the plateaus, and coming to the Thar Desert. Only one desert is there, that is Thar Desert. It is situated in Rajasthan, where the rainfall is very less, that is 100 to 150 millimeters per year is the lesser rainfall. There you can find the deserts, and in India we are having only one desert, that is the Thar Desert. And what is the next physical feature after the desert? That is the coastal plains. These coastal plains are also again western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. You can see the western and the eastern coastal plains, because as you know that our India is an island filled with the oceans, Arabian and Bay of Bengal, and so Indian Ocean. So like this, you can see the ocean, and so these places are the sea coastal. These are the coastal regions. And when compared to the western coastal region, eastern coastal region is little bit broad. Western coastal is a narrow bit. And in the western coastal region, we are having three regions. We are having three parts. This one, first one is the Konkan coast. It is in Maharashtra and Goa. Here only, I'll explain in the map again. Maharashtra and Goa, Konkan coast is, and Kerala coast, this is in Karnataka, and Malabar coast, this is in Kerala. So these are the western coastal regions, western coastal plains. They are also more fertile. And coming to the eastern side, Krishna Godavari, Brahmaputra, Krishna Godavari and Tungabhadra rivers are flowing in the eastern side. So the plains are filled with very fertile. And if we see here also three parts of coastal plains are there. First one is Utkala coast, which is in Odisha. Here Utkala coast, that is in Odisha, and Sarkar coast, that is in Andhra Pradesh. Here this W shape. And the next one is the Coromandel coast, that is in Tamil Nadu. These are the coastal plains, western three parts and eastern also three parts. Is it clear to you? Yeah. So western three parts and eastern. Western parts are the Konkan coast, Kerala coast, and the Malabar coast. And eastern parts are Utkala coast, Sarkar coast, and Coromandel coast, eastern parts. So these are about the coastal plains. Then coming to the last physical feature, that is the island. So in Arabian Sea, we can see what are the islands which are situated in the Arabian Sea. Lakshadweep in Arabian Sea, and in Bay of Bengal, we can have Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So this is all about the futures, relief futures of our India. Coming to the important points which you have to remember is how the Himalayas are helping us, because they are extended very high in the northern part. They are protecting us from the cold winds. They are objecting the cold winds blowing inside the India, so that the northern parts of India are safe from the cold breezes. And we are getting more minerals from the Himalayan mountains. Not only this, that is a good tourist path. We are getting tourist income also. Minerals also, we are getting more minerals in the Himalayas. From the Himalayas we are getting. And not only that, the glacier is from the Himalayas which are getting water also. The river flowings are... throughout the year, we can have the river flowing there, that are perennial rivers. So, this is all about the physical futures or the physical futures are the relief futures of our India. And I am going to explain everything in detail again on the map, where they are situated and how they are bordered, what are the neighboring countries of India, everything we are going to learn it on the map. Thank you children for watching. Please do subscribe my channel and ask your friends also to subscribe. Thank you. Thank you very much.